have Chris Bunch come and just talk to you real quick about conservation efforts in Macomb County. We're going to be looking at some of what's going on in the Detroit River today, but equally as important, we have things going on in Macomb County. And since Chris Bunch has taken the executive director role at Six Rivers Regional Land Conservancy, we've seen a major uptick in the importance of conservation in Macomb County. And he's going to just highlight that. So Chris Bunch has joined the staff as a director in April 2011. He is a land protection professional developing a wide range of related projects. He also does fundraising, grant implementation, and management, organizational development and management, and developing supporting policies. He also serves on a Blue Ribbon Advisory Group for the state game areas for the state of Michigan, and he also sits on the Macomb County Water Resources Advisory Council. So, Chris Munch.
Thank you very much, everybody. Thanks for the opportunity to be here, and I guess it's all up to me. If it's a hostage crisis, it's my fault. So I'll try and make sure that I follow the three B's of public speaking, right? Be honest, be brief, and be seated, because we all want to be out on the boat. So I'm going to take just a, I'm going to go off script for half a second. Jerry is one of my board members, so I'll get in a lot of trouble, but I want to tell you just very briefly. It was about 30 years ago that I got started in the conservation field as a volunteer and as a snot-nosed, idealistic kid. And a big chunk of what we were talking about back then and trying to get fixed were CSOs. And that's been going on forever and ever and ever. And I'm a native Michigander, so I've watched Candace as Secretary of State. I've watched her as a congresswoman. And I got to tell you something. I am just so thrilled to watch her when she gets up and talks about what she's doing here. Because she's so animated and so excited, and it's clear that it's really important and personal to her. And you guys are so lucky to have an advocate like that that's making this stuff happen. And she's making a lot of really cool stuff happen. It's a lot different than it's been for a lot of years.
I did not pay him.
No, she didn't. But I tell you, it's an honor and a pleasure to be able to spend time with her. And I met with Candace a couple of weeks ago to talk about a project we were doing. She very graciously and very directly stayed single-minded and single-focused and said, listen, I'm clearing up the CSOs. You guys do your thing, we'll do our thing. And that's fabulous because it's that focus that's getting all this done. But we're also working on some joint projects, and that's in the invasive species area. We'll talk about that in a little bit. So you guys probably know who Six Rivers is. There's some stuff on the table. What I'm really gonna do is skip ahead to a project that we're working on here. And I'm going to use something that I've heard Candace say a lot and that I learned back in the days when I was a carpenter, and that is the plumber's rule, right? Payday is Friday, and everything goes downhill. So this project that we're working on up in New Baltimore is really important to everybody in Lake St. Clair and downward. So you all know a little bit about who we are, C3 Land Conservancy. We acquire land and interest in land for conservation purposes. We work in the Emerald Crown, the northern part of the Metro Detroit region. The last couple of weeks, I've worked almost exclusively in Macomb County, which, by the way, has not been terrible because I've been on Lake St. Clair quite a bit. So this is the project I want to talk to you about, our Anchor Bay Woods Preserve, which is up in New Baltimore. And since I came on back in 2011, there has been a lot of talk about the need to protect this 300-acre forested wetland. This last largest wet mesic flatwoods is the scientific term that is a mature forest. It's a remnant. There's a larger piece, but it's owned by Metro Parks, and it's downriver. And this is unique to this part of the world, especially to Southeast Michigan and Northern Ohio. So this is the last largest privately held one. And for years and years, people have been trying to develop it, and you can sort of see what's going on around it. So there's about 300 acres left, and one day, after being here a couple of years and doing a lot of work, trying to get the state of Michigan to create an Anchor Bay State Park, and trying to get some trust fund money to help acquire some of this, I just finally one day, in my ultimate patience, said, look, we're just going to start buying properties. And of course, what happened is I'm in a lot of trouble now. We started buying properties, and now we got to keep moving forward. So we need your help to do this. So we've invested about $380,000 so far that has come from grants, and they've come from grants from other areas, from foundations that are state or national level. And we were just awarded a $450,000 matching grant from one of the foundations that funded one of our initial acquisitions. But it's a matching grant, it's a one-to-one grant. We've got to raise another $450,000 to release those $450,000. And these guys are deadly serious about starting to see the locals contribute to acquiring this and preserving this and protecting this. So I need a lot of help in finding $450,000 to release that other $450,000. And the whole project we are estimating is about $2 million worth. So we'll be about two-thirds of the way there, I would say, with what we've invested when we come up with and match that $450,000. But there's still more to come up with to buy those other properties. Some of our funders have been Ducks Unlimited, got us a $100,000 grant through NOCA, North American Wetlands Conservation Act, which is a federal program. Exalta contributed $10,000 of match money. And then the Carls Foundation is the one that has funded some of our initial acquisitions. And then I convinced my board, I don't know if Jerry was there or not, to let me mortgage a piece for $77,000. So somehow I've got to come up with that and pay that off. At any rate, there are several properties left to acquire. We're looking for some help in doing that. And I'll just finish out by saying, people mentioned mentioned invasive species. We're doing a lot of cooperative invasive species work. We are the fiduciary, Six Rivers is the fiduciary for the Lake St. Clair Cooperative Invasive Species Management Area. It's a partnership of public and private agencies that go out there to take care of invasive species like Phragmites. So we're doing a joint project with Public Works. I was just out there watching the work the other day where we are cutting and drowning Phragmites in one area, and we are treating it chemically in another area to see which one works the best. We are managing on behalf of roads the treatment of Phragmites along the roads, along with numerous other things, boat washes and education campaigns and so forth. So we're working hard to try and keep Lake St. Clair the fabulous resource that it is, and to improve the water quality. So I'm just going to finish by saying this is why Six Rivers exists. This is why we do what we do. And I'm picking on Macomb Township because I'm in the middle of a project with them right now. This is what Macomb Township looked like in 1961. There's what it looked like in 1997. And there it is in 2015. So, I would make a couple of arguments there. I come from a rural community, so I'm convinced I'm going to die of old age at a traffic light down here. And I would say things were a little different in 1961 than they are now. Obviously, there's some significant impacts to water quality from all of the impervious surface that exists now with all of that development. And there are some hard infrastructure costs that we have incurred because of that as well. Water lines and sewer lines and roads and the other public costs as well. Police, fire, so on and so forth. So if I were to go all the way back to that Anchor Bay Woods picture and show you all about 300 acres of forest, what I would tell you is the cows don't call 911 and the trees aren't going to school. So an ounce of prevention prevents $30 million or $300 million or many, many millions of dollars worth of restoration and rehabilitation work. So we're here to help try and conserve and preserve the best of what we've got and sustain and improve our quality of life. So let's go for a boat ride. Thank you and good night.